probably know what would happen if I poured this entire bottle of ink into this glass of water. It would turn the water black, and then I would try to dare one of you freshman guys or somebody to drink it. But what if I just put in one drop of ink? What do you think would happen then? It probably wouldn't have quite the same effect as if I poured in a lot of the ink, but maybe it would turn some of the water black, but again, it probably wouldn't do all that much, right? Well, check this out. It takes a little bit longer, you see, but watch as the ink begins to really spread all throughout the water. You see, even one small drop makes a really big difference. We're in week two of a series which we're calling You Are the Church. And last week, Gretchen talked about what the church is and how important your contribution is to the church as a high school student. Tonight, we're going to talk a little bit more about the difference that your involvement in the church can make. And to do so, I want to take a look at a story of Jesus in the Gospel of John. In John chapter 6, we see that after Jesus has performed several different miracles, a large crowd begins to follow him everywhere he goes. And Jesus sees this huge crowd of people looking for him, and so he turns to one of his disciples, Philip, and he asks him, "Where can we buy bread to feed all of these people?" And now this is kind of a funny scenario because Jesus already knew what he was going to do. And so he was pretty much just testing Philip. And you'll see in a second, but if you're wondering, Philip probably doesn't pass the test. See, Philip responds to Jesus by saying, "I have no idea where we'll get enough food to feed everybody. Even if we worked for months, we still wouldn't have enough money to buy enough food to feed a crowd this big." But then one of the other disciples, his name was Andrew, kind of notices something and starts to speak up. And what's really interesting is that Andrew tells Jesus that there's a young boy in the crowd who has 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. And then Andrew almost seems like he starts to backtrack in a sense. Like he feels like everybody's looking at him like he's crazy because 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish couldn't feed a crowd of this many people. And so he almost kind of says, yeah, maybe not. Maybe that's not really that good of an idea. And I'll pick up reading from John 6, and here's what happens next. "Tell everyone to sit down," Jesus said. So they all sat down on the grassy slopes. The men alone numbered about 5,000. And then Jesus took the loaves from the boy and gave thanks to God and distributed them to all the people. Afterward, he did the same thing with the fish, and they all ate as much as they wanted. And after everyone was full, Jesus told his disciples, "Now gather the leftovers so that nothing is wasted." So they picked up the pieces and filled 12 baskets with scraps left by the people who had eaten from the 5 barley loaves. I wonder if you've ever felt like you don't have what it takes to make a real difference. I think that's how the boy in the story felt a little bit. If he's anything like me, he probably even ran through all the things that he didn't have to contribute, all the reasons why he couldn't make a real difference. Maybe, for example, I only have a little bit of bread. I only have a couple of fish. I don't have food for 5,000 people. I don't really have all that much money. If only I had some more time, then I could figure something out to feed all these people. Or man, if there's only a Chick-fil-A or a Panera nearby, then I could grab lunch for everybody in the crowd. But what's interesting is that the boy actually did have something that can make a difference. He had 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. And even though that wasn't really much, it was basically just a sack lunch, and maybe it was even all the food that his entire family had, he still was willing to give up what he had in order to allow Jesus to do something incredible with it. And what does Jesus do? He uses it to do something miraculous, something that none of the disciples or anybody in that crowd, including the boy, could have ever imagined. Jesus multiplied the 5 loaves of bread and the 2 fish in order to feed well over 5,000 people. And if you caught it, they had leftovers. And see, and many of the people in the crowd that day began to realize that Jesus really is the prophet that was talked about all throughout the Old Testament, that Jesus is Yahweh, that he's God in the flesh. And so what does that mean for you? Well, I think when we say you are the church, what that means is that we believe that you can make a real difference with what you have. Now, I totally understand that you're in high school. You might even feel like you don't really have all that much to offer. You probably don't have much money. You're not in positions of leadership or really given the responsibility to make big decisions. But just like the boy in the story, it even might be easy for you to run through all the reasons why you can't contribute because you're too young. But listen, Just because you're young does not make your contribution any less. It doesn't make the role that you can play any less significant. You might feel like all you have to offer is a drop, not an entire bottle. But if you check this out, a drop actually does a lot more than you might realize. At the beginning, I put one drop of ink into this glass, and by now, the entire glass of water is black. See, every drop matters. The boy in the story just had a few pieces of bread and a couple of fish. You could say that all he had was a drop. It definitely wasn't much. It definitely wasn't enough to feed the entire crowd, but he used what he had. And then Jesus did something really incredible with it. So what's your drop? What is it that you have to contribute? Maybe it's your time. We talk a lot about serving at church. There's over 200 middle school and high school students who serve at Chapelstreet. A common place for you guys as students to serve is with kids or special needs ministries. But there's also a lot of other places that you could give your time. Serving as a greeter or as an usher on a Sunday morning, for example. Helping with tech, volunteering in the food pantry. Or maybe you even just love to sing or you play an instrument. My encouragement to you would be to pursue that. There's so many awesome ways for you to use your time, and we love to see more and more students contributing in meaningful ways in the church. Or maybe it's your money. You might not be able to give $1,000 to support the church, but maybe you can give $1 or maybe $10. Maybe it's your ideas. I know what it's like to be young and to feel like your voice or your opinions just don't really matter. And when that's the case, it can be easier to just not want to share them. But that's not true. Your ideas do matter. The way that you see things and what you think about things is really important and something that we really value. Maybe for you, it's even just being involved in what's happening at the church. The main way to do that is by attending weekend worship services. Like Gretchen said last week, you bring a passion and an energy that is absolutely contagious. I think that even your attendance at various church events, things like Micah 6:8 or the stadium service, go a really long way. Your involvement in those things is a really great contribution, even if it just feels like a drop. You see, we're all better when you use your drop. The church isn't just about what the adults do. It's certainly not just what the people on staff do. The church is about everybody, regardless of your age. Everybody putting in a drop to contribute. And then God using that to do some really cool things. You are the church. You matter, and you can make a difference. And it's so great to watch how God uses you, even if it's just a drop, to make people feel welcome, to make an impact in the church. It's great to watch the ways that you guys as students get to learn and grow as you get more involved. It's awesome to watch you learn more about yourselves and then even learn more about how God has wired you as a person. Because here's the deal. You're the church here at Chapelstreet for sure, but you're also the church when you go to college or when you start working after high school and when you're my age and when you're your parents' age and so on. The church, again, is about everybody, regardless of your age, everybody putting in a drop to contribute and then watching how God uses that in really significant ways. You are the church, and you, your gifts, your life circumstances, your passions and your abilities really matter. So the only question is, how are you going to use your drop?